Well, I met Steve in the mid-70s when he painted a car for my dad, a 33 Plymouth convertible that they've owned since. Steve has about 12,000 square feet here, and the shop floor is about 10,000 square feet. He's been here since about December of 1992. So I started working for him in 1993, and I've never stopped.
Dave and I have worked together for over 20 years now, and it's amazing how his thought process and ideas, how parallel they are to mine. And obviously that works good for us as a team. On our first interaction with a new customer, what we like to decide is whether they're going for a simple build or a restoration or actually a creation. A simple hot rod build probably needs a little design work and very little bricklaying. A restoration is pretty straightforward. You're gonna follow the example of the car being built when it was brand new. Now, if you get into a realm with a new customer where you're designing and creating, you're changing body parts, trim, and most likely the motor.
A strong design direction will drive the theme of any car project that we do in the shop. It's really important for us to guide the client through the design and build process so that we can end up with the best possible finished result.
The first thing to do is to get an idea of what the customer's desired theme is that he wants to go with. Sometimes it's dictated by the motor, sometimes it's dictated by the style of the interior that he wants to create, and sometimes it's dictated by the colors that they're going to go after.
There are just so many different builds that a guy could do to even one car. The computer-aided design that we have available at the shop is a great system for marrying new technology with the old world craftsmanship of the car projects that we do here at the shop.
In the old days when everybody was drawing with a pencil and a paper and they were coloring in colors with a pencil, I mean, they were making one rendering after another, and you can see how much time that would take up, which time converts to money.
Well, I've been sketching for cars for 30 years, and if I want to make a change like color, I have to redo the drawing all the way through. And so the computer totally enhances that aspect of it to look at the different color combinations in a quicker manner.
The use of a computer in designing doesn't necessarily change the design process, other than the fact that it does speed it up rather than doing design work with a pencil and paper. But what you have to understand is a lot of people can't imagine the end product in their mind. They just can't see it in their mind. And especially with colors or color combinations. If you can sit down and quickly sketch something out on a computer, you can present something in front of a client, and you can, at the click of a mouse, you can change the color of the interior, or you can two-tone the vehicle, or you can take layers off and extend the fenders, or you can change wheels really quickly.
Well, the computer really enhances the aspects of color and the speed at which you can give different looks to a car.
Black fenders, that really helps a lot.
Yeah, that tones it down some, that's great.
Yep.
With what Steve does, this shop, it turns out some absolutely amazing stuff. I know there's a lot of people that are into cars, but they may not necessarily be able to visualize how to color scheme things. Looking at the grill and the paint job and this, there's so much going on with the front of the bus without being able to see how you can tie it all together. I mean, there's so much character to the front of this, it could get too busy if you do too many things to it. And without being able to see it, you're guessing. And then what happens? You put all the work into painting it and doing it the way you thought was gonna be right. And it's like, boy, now we gotta redo this. And I can't expect, you know, anybody to eat that. It's my decision on what to do. And if it's wrong, that just costs me more. So being able to have that is a great savings on my end.
A lot of times in a sketch scenario where we're trying to work out different exterior layouts, say for bumpers, we could show the client on the computer three or four variations, and from there we can select the best design and build it. So the bumpers on this Corvette project were designed in the computer, and a direction was chosen by the owner, and we've just come in and made up a mock-up so we could see it full scale on the car. From here, they'll be fabricated in metal and then fit to the car and mounted.
technology seems to enter into all of the builder's mindset nowadays. But what's really interesting to a client is the more old world craftsmanship and old world tools that are used that actually go into building and customizing cars. It's almost like black magic to them. You get your credibility, basically, mostly, out of how many old world skills and tools you can use to get your end goal. Our shop was one of the first shops to have a website that offered progress photos of the client's project. And this allows the client to see what happened that week or that day on his car. So the computer technology with email and video has greatly enhanced communication between the long distance client. That part has just changed this business or this hobby tremendously, just tremendously.